For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
The tenure of the present Left Democratic Front government of Kerala has seen major improvements in public education and public health care. Infrastructure in government schools has been upgraded in a big way, which has resulted in the number of students in government schools going up by more than 40,000, even as the number of students in private schools went down by almost 30,000. Government hospitals have been upgraded, which was crucial in helping the state tackle the COVID pandemic. Kerala has the lowest case fatality rate in India. During the pandemic, Kerala was able to provide the necessary healthcare to all those who needed it for free using its public health system. During this period, the state saw the mobilization of the government machinery, cooperatives, public sector industries, women's collectives, mass organizations, and trade unions in providing relief to the people to prevent hunger and to ensure the supply of essential commodities. In 2018, Kerala was hit by the most severe floods in nearly a century, and the government spearheaded the rescue, relief, and rebuilding efforts in a manner that won the appreciation of many diverse sections of people. Another major thing to note is that public sector industries, which had been run down by the previous Congress-led government, are being turned around during the tenure of this government. Pensions for the elderly have been expanded, which acted as an important safety net for almost 6 million people. The government also set in motion a housing program which has built 250,000 houses for the poor in the state. All of these have contributed tremendously to increasing the popularity of the left government. The Left Democratic Front had to overcome huge challenges in order to win these elections. The biggest media houses in Kerala, both in print and visual media, are all right-wing. Whatever falsehoods are uttered by the Congress and the BJP, these media outlets tend to amplify those. And then they invent many more falsehoods on their own in order to slander the left. All sorts of false allegations have been raised against the left government in the past few months. They were all soon exposed to be false. But lies travel faster than truth, and the right wing hopes that such fake news will have an impact on the people. Another important factor is the combined assault launched by the BJP and the Congress. The BJP government at the center has been trying to starve the Kerala government, denying it funds for the development of the state. When the Kerala government found alternative methods of funding, the BJP tried to use central investigative agencies to put a stop to that. The Congress went on a campaign to prevent people from contributing to the Chief Minister's Distress Relief Fund, which is an important source of funds to provide relief to the people during times of crisis like the COVID pandemic or floods. There have been attacks by both the BJP and the Congress on Kerala's cooperatives. The BJP has also used central investigative agencies to tarnish the Life Mission, which is Kerala's public housing program. And the Congress announced that they will scrap the Life Mission if they come to power. Both the Congress and the BJP have repeatedly tried to undermine the Kerala government's efforts to tackle the pandemic crisis. The people are witness to all of these, but the Congress and the BJP were hoping that the narrative spun by the
right-wing media will be enough for them to discredit the left and win the elections. Clearly, that plan did not succeed.
Yeah, cantar.